Hi everyone, I am Cataldo Musto from the University of Bari, and in this presentation I will introduce you our idea of building queryable user profiles, and in particular I will show you how we have tried to move forward this idea by introducing conversational agents in a platform for holistic user modeling. So in this presentation we will mainly talk about user modeling. And in particular, we'll talk about user modeling in the ecosystem era. What are we talking about? The main idea behind the division of the so-called ecosystem is that a profile of a person, of a user, can be built by acquiring and aggregating personal data that are spread on social networks such as YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and so on. In our previous work that has been recently published on User Modeling and User Adaptive Interaction journal on this year, we have tried to introduce our holistic user modeling strategy that has a good overlap with the ideas of the so-called ecosystem, because we extract the user's personal data from several sources, such as social media and personal devices, such as smartphones and smartwatches and so on. We process this data and we map this data to a set of 8 different facets that you can see in these slides, though demographic, interests, affects, social relation, physical states, and so on, that represent, the main characteristics that can describe a person. This is just a conceptual model, but we have also built a platform that allows to concretely build this holistic user model that is called Mirror. Here you can see in this slide and in the following ones, you can see some of the screenshots of this platform. Each user, when she connects to the system, she can connect her own personal identities to the system, and she can enable the extraction of the data. Once the user has enabled the extraction of the data, personal data are extracted and processed by Mirror, and they are used to build a holistic user model of the user. Once the profile is built, it is made available through this kind of dashboard to the final user, and the user can check the personal information that are stored in the profile by clicking on the different facets that she can see on the left side of the screen. This dashboard includes checking the trend of the mood over time, checking the amount of activities that the user has done day by day, checking the places visited based on the geotags shared on social media or the personal interest of the user. So this is our starting point. So we have a conceptual model for building such a rich and comprehensive representation of the person. And we also have a platform that allows to concretely build these user models. But there is a room for improvement of the current strategy, because in our opinion, first, the overall transparency may be improved, because we think that users should be every time aware of the information which is encoded in her own profile. But the interaction with the dashboard, like the one I have just to show you, can be difficult, especially for beginner users. So it can be difficult, for example, to check what are the current interests that are encoded in the profile. Similarly, with the current implementation of the system, it is also difficult for the user to get some valuable insight by checking the information that is stored in the profile. So, for example, we have the information about the amount of time the user has slept, but we can say to the user whether she has slept enough or not. So, what we have tried to do in this work is to improve the way people can access to the information that is encoded in their holistic user profiles. And our idea is to exploit conversational agents for this goal. Conversational agents have been popularized by Alexa, Siri, Google Now, and so on in recent years. And they try to spread a very intuitive idea because they acquire natural language requests, they understand the request, and they provide an answer in natural language typically. And this is done for very general purposes services, such as listening to some music. Our idea is to replicate this strategy in user profiling. So we want to make a first step toward a queryable user profile. So our idea is that a user should express her information need in natural language to the platform, and the platform should be provided with the ability of answering to the question that user has expressed in natural language as well. In this way, in our opinion, we can make easier to access the information that is encoded in the profile, because this kind of interaction is much more natural and simple to be used by also beginner users as well. So the main contribution of this work is represented by MirrorBot. MirrorBot is a conversational agent that is built on top of Mirror, so our platform for holistic user modeling. On the left side of this figure, you can see the general workflow, and I just want to highlight you the main features that we have implemented. The first one is represented by personalized services, because we allow the user to ask for services similar to those that are available in Alexa, so music recommendation, news recommendation, recipe recommendation, and so on. But differently from Alexa and other similar devices, the user can also inspect, in order to have more transparency, the information that is encoded in the profile of the user. In order to, and this is the focus of this presentation actually, in order to trigger this kind of usage of the system, as you can see from the workflow, the core of the whole system is the intent recognizer. The goal of the intent recognizer is to implement a natural language understanding strategy, because the goal of this model is to acquire the request of the user and understand the request the user has formulated. The output of this model is the so-called intent, which is a representation of the informative need of the user. If we refer again to the previous example concerning Amazon Alexa, if the user asks "Play Africa by Toto," the intent, which is recognized by the intent recognizer model, which is implemented in Alexa, is that the user wants to play some music. So the goal of the intent recognizer is to understand what the user wants when she formulates a particular request. In our case, we have implemented this model by exploiting Google Dialogflow system. So the main question that we have to answer now is, what kind of questions can we handle through our system? Well, as Amazon Alexa has intents that are directly related to the services it can provide, MirrorBot has intents that are directly mapped to the facets of the holistic user models. So for each facet of the holistic user models, as those I have previously shown you, we have an intent in MirrorBot. To be more precise, we have two intents for each facet of the holistic user model, because the user can express simple informative queries for each of the intents, so I'll match this day to day, but she also can express an informative need that is oriented to get some insights from the platform. So for example, did I sleep enough today? So we have 16 intents in total that needs to be encoded in our conversational agent. The intent recognizer is basically a machine learning module. So in order to allow this model to correctly recognize all the possible way the user can express her own informative need, we have to train this model. So for each intent that we have provided in the, with the intent recognizer, we defined around 20, 30 sentences that are used to feed and train the algorithm. In particular, we try to encode all the possible utterances that can be used to express a particular information need. In the figure, you can see some of the expressions that we have used to train our behavior intent. I don't have time to provide more details of this strategy, but the very high-level idea of this module is to carry out tasks similar like this. So we have questions of the user, and these questions are correctly classified in the intents they basically refer. So if the user asks, tell me about my personality traits, the model understands that the user is looking for information about her psychological traits. Finally, the last module of the workflow is the generator. The goal of the generator is to produce the output that the user receives based on the intent that is previously recognized. Here on the left side of the figure, you can see some of the outputs, an example of the interaction with the system. So if the user asks for the age, the system replies with the age, and so on and so forth. You can see the example there. What I want to emphasize here is that when the user expresses informative intent, there is no computation which is carried out. So the intent is recognized, we query the holistic user model, we do receive the information from the holistic user model, and we use this information to fill in a natural language template that is presented to the user. Conversely, when the user expresses an insight-based intent, there is some computation to be carried out. In particular, we made, for example, some kind of comparison between the values that are stored in the user profile and some threshold values. So, for example, the amount, the average amount of sleep time per night. So, as a recap, this is the pipeline that we implement, and we basically carry out this step. We acquire a holistic user model, we recognize user requests that are formulated in natural language, and we generate the a natural language answer related to user informative need. In the experimental evaluation, we try to answer basically two different questions. The first one is a more qualitative question. So, we aim to understand the opinion of the user in terms of usability, ease of use, and learning curve. The second one is much more quantitative analysis, because we evaluated the time needed through a conversational interface with respect to a classical web-based interface to complete some tasks. So we calculated, we defined a set of 8 different tasks related to checking the information stored in the user model, and we calculated the time needed to complete this task. So we, to this end, we carried out a user study with 76 subjects with a low experience with chatbots. For the first research question, we defined a questionnaire that was based on a system usability survey. But for the second one, as I said, we defined some tasks and we calculated the time in second needed. As for the first research question, as you can see in the column, you have the metric as well as the questions and the percentage of user who completely agree or agree with the statement. As you can see, most of the users had a positive opinion towards the system, so they liked the, in general, the idea behind the system. As for the second research question, which is more interesting, you can see that for each task, generally speaking, we had one task for each facet of the user profile, we had a significant reduction in the task completion time by using MirrorBot. So the adoption of a conversational interface leads to a reduction of the time needed to check the information which is stored in the profile. And this is confirmed also for the other tasks that we carried out. So users had a very general positive opinion and we can access to the information in a very effective way. In general, we had a 40.3% of reduction of the time needed to complete tasks, 7 seconds on average, which is quite good. So as a recap, through this paper, we made a first step towards queryable user profiles. We started from Mirror, a platform from holistic user modeling implemented as through a classical web interface, and we provided Mirror as a contribution Mirrorbot, so a conversational agent built on top on Mirrorbot. As we have shown in our experiments, our system had a good impact on users, and we had also a significant reduction of task completion time. We have a demo available if you want to try the system or interact with the system. And as future work, we hope at UMAP 2021, we will also evaluate personalized services. We'll try to integrate also different interaction methods, such as social robots. And we'll also try to train more sophisticated intents, such as those connected to personal lifestyle. That's it. Thank you.